Nobody knows where the rivers flow, and I call it home. And there's no more lies in the darkness is light, and nobody cries. There's only butterflies.
Hey, let's get the camera up and running and should have the music off now. Welcome everyone. Just checking to make sure that you can both see and hear. If you can, type into the chat. So Jill, I know you had music. Great. I'm getting no response from Brian. He's been on for a while. Maybe we should wake Brian up. I should have played the music a little bit louder. Jodine, welcome. Welcome. Great to see you here. Jill. All right. We've got some people hopping on. Welcome. I hope you all had some amazing wins since the Tuesday webinar. My name is Fran Henry. You've probably seen me in the chat on the webinars. I am a certified ultimate game of life coach, and I coach at all levels of the game, and I absolutely love working with each level of the game. And I'm also a coach you graduate, and I've been coaching for, oh gosh, I think it's 13 or 14 years now. So I'm excited to be here. I had hoped to be on 2 weeks ago, but tech challenges prevented that. So Gemini tested everything out. It's all running well tonight. And hopefully your systems are too. I'd love to hear some wins. So if you had some wins in your environments, upgraded an environment or something really shifted in your mindset, your memetics, your brain, your thought process, I'd love to hear that. So, okay, Brian, you're back and good to go. I like that. So what are some wins? Type them into the chat and we'll read them off and celebrate them. And then also, if one of you would like to test your system and share a quick win, I'd be glad to give you an audio and video invite, and we'll hear your win. So Brian says, I put more visual anchors in my environments to remind me of my goals. What specifically, Brian, so that others can get some ideas from you, what specifically did you put in your environment, and what was the result that it brought you? So you had a thought, you took an action, and it sounds like you're getting results. So I'm just curious, what were the results that you got? Jodine, how about you? And Jill, what are some wins coming from your changing your environments, upgrading your environment? And as I said, I had one coaching request from Tenzin, so I don't see her on yet. So hopefully when she gets on, she'll start typing into the chat and we'll know that she's there. And if not, I will open it up. One invitation to those of you who are on. So Jill says, been investing, love that change of wording, more time in nature and being more present during that time. Nice. Jodine says, finally got my patio cleaned. So finally sounds like that's been an intention for a long time. and you got it done. What were the feelings when you did these things? When you upgraded your, or you invested specifically time and nature focused, when you cleaned your patio, when you put those visual anchors, what kind of feelings did you get? You know, we talk about happy, healthy, and wealthy. So happy is a feeling. Brian says, Jim showed me the $1 million bill on a webinar recently. Yes. I printed off a few copies and put them up in different places where I would see them. The result is my noticing new opportunities and smaller opportunities that were distracting me from no longer and are no longer enticing me. Cool. So that's amazing that you put a visual anchor for your financial environment and it's helped you to stay more focused, to know what to say yes to, what to say no to, and to simplify so that you can focus more on the things you really want to accomplish. And the feeling is empowerment and focus. Awesome. That's great. Good work, Brian. All right. And so Jill likes your idea, Brian. Looks like she's going to take that on too. So right now I'm seeing Jodine. Chris, welcome, Chris. We're sharing wins right now. Jill, Jim, JB, Henry, and Brian. So those of you who've joined us, if you would like to, this is a one-time offer because remember, this is your last, second, and final coaching, Jim. So this is a one-time offer. Ideally, you send in your coaching requests ahead of time. I get to look at them. I know what we need to coach around, and I can pick the ones that I think will be most beneficial to the group as a whole. And since right now, yes, I know, Jim. But you said you were going still, so I was honoring that. So anyway, for those of you who would like to take an opportunity and to have some coaching around something for your either your environment or your goals, you do have the opportunity. If there's nothing to coach around, then we can all take the evening off and go work on our game. But I know the value of coaching. I'd love to help support you and really stepping up your game. This is your final week of your 21-day challenge. So you set goals, you had a strategy to reach them, you had more information, understanding how valuable the environments can be, and how if you mold them to support your goal, it makes it much easier to achieve your goal. So why don't you, those of you who are on, type in your goal. What was your one goal for your 21-day challenge? And then also, if you can just give us kind of a percent to goal. So if you had an intention to release some weight, what's your percent to goal? You've got really to the end of the week, till next Tuesday. Are you two-thirds, three-quarters of the way to your goal? That sort of thing. If it was a financial goal, if it, you know, whatever your goal was, type in your goal. So Jill says goal, an hour a day in nature. Okay, and you've already reported that you did invest more time in nature and that you clarified your goal a little bit to actually make you more focused. And then Jill also had saving the big goals for the 90 day. Ah, so you put your life on hold for the next level of the game. Okay, I know how you're playing, Jill. And that's good. There's no judgment or criticism around that. That's how you can space things out so that your life becomes simple and you accomplish what you want. So, Brian, what's your goal? So Jill says easing into it, getting small wins. Perfect, perfect. We talked about that in the how to win the game. So Brian says to create $1,000 a month additional. I'm 70% there and have a strategy in place to create that last 30% by the end of the month. Awesome. Good for you. High five. All right. Chris and Jodine, love to hear from you. What is your goal and how well are you doing towards your goal? And then also, if you're interested in having some coaching, type that into the chat. And if you already did and I missed it, do it again. It's just an exercise to prove that you mean it. And we will give you, you don't have to do video if you don't want to, but we do have to have audio. So last call. Tenzin, I'm thought did intend to be on. I'm not sure whether something else had hopped up, but she did have the one and only coaching. Well, let me just check and make sure nothing's gone in since I looked last. Making sure that, no, she has the only request in. So Jodine says, I wanted 20 blog posts written by the end of the month to get my website rolling September 1st. I have two left, so that means you've done 18. So I will be able to go over the 20. Awesome, so you can actually exceed your expectations or your goal. That's great, Jodine. Now, what was your experience of that? Being at this point, knowing that up to here you had one main goal, you had a strategy, I'm assuming to commit a specific amount of time every day, and you are almost at your goal with the potential to exceed it. So how's that feeling for you? Chris says, increasing my number of steps to speed up weight release, I feel less stressed and anxiety. Feels great. Okay, so Chris, I'm going to hit you on this one because was this your goal? Was the goal was a specific number of steps or was it weight release? How did you actually state your goal? Because I'm curious to see what was your specific goal and were there some side benefits to it or just what's going on with you? So Jodine says, I feel less stress and anxiety. It feels great. Yeah, so that's really important to realize that when you have a goal and you set up a strategy that's appropriate for attaining that goal and you follow through, you take the actions that you've committed to, then you find out what is possible, whether the goal was attainable, whether it's going to actually be easy or whether you're stressing out over it. And then being able to do the same thing. What you've done, Jodine, is repeatable. Next time you have a goal, maybe three, if you join us for the 90 day, or you focus on happiness, health, and well, and you have one goal in each of those, you know how to step it up now because you've created success at the 21 day one goal challenge. So that's great. Okay, I'm still not seeing Tenzin on, so. Nope. So last call. Is there anybody who would like some coaching on either this or if you have any questions about the 90-day challenge, I can answer them. If not, I can always bring Jim on to share. So you have our full attention. How would you like us to support you? And I'd love to hear from everyone on this. I see Chris is typing. Or not. So questions, coaching requests, or any other way that we can support you. I'm just curious why you're thinking about that. I know the last coaching Jim did two different coaching opportunities, and I'm assuming that it was really helpful for you all to hear those and to learn from them. Was it also intimidating? Did you at any way feel that you, being in the seat for coaching, would be uncomfortable? And I'm asking that because we don't know what it looks like from your perspective. But we love to learn and to have feedback. So the people looked to me like they were quite comfortable being coached. They had great results. And they, I'm sure, moved forward after the coaching gym. So I'm just curious what's keeping you all from taking an opportunity to have coaching and to move your game along with the help of professional coaches. So just checking in with you. So Chris says, I've been stuck in a lot of places, but have had success with exercise and am at amplitude. So going for reachable win, increase exercise. Finally, get over 5K. Okay, so I'm still not sure what your original goal was, whether it was just the specific steps and see what having 5,000 steps or 8,000 or whatever your goal was. What was your specific goal? And the second question is, would you be willing to come on and have some coaching around that? And if so, hi, Bonnie, welcome. I think we were just talking about you, Bonnie, talking about the coach, people who stepped up for coaching last time, and what did they show us about how, was it comfortable? Did they make it along? What was your experience of being coached, Bonnie? If I remember correctly, you were one of the people who were coached. So I put out the request that anybody who wants coaching, Tenzin had the only request for coaching, and she's not yet joined the webinar. She may not be able to get on. Don't know what's going on there, but just checking to see if anybody wants coaching. So it was a good experience. What did you actually accomplish? What was the result of getting the coaching and making your commitment? Did it help move your game forward? What was the benefit? How would you encourage others to step up and have that same experience? Welcome, Sam. I see Sam just hopped on. Sam, we're sharing wins. We're sharing what the perceived value of coaching is. And we have an offer out if anyone would like to have some coaching. The one person with the request has not joined us yet. And we're going to give this last call for coaching. And if no one would like to have coaching, then I think we'll call it a night and you all can go work on your commitments to your game. So Bonnie says, overwhelming to work on too many areas at once. Yeah, it is overwhelming. We talk about multitasking. You'll learn more about this in the 90 day. There's a great exercise Jim does, and it will really drive home that there is no such thing as multitasking. We can switch between numerous activities in a short period of time, but there's no such thing as multitasking. You really are only working on one thing at a time. Bonnie says, I'm starting money and you tonight and play to win, so I jump start finances. Nice, nice. Okay, very good. All right, so last call. If you would like some coaching, please type that in. And if you wanted to share your goal, you can share that. So Bonnie, you're almost done. Nice. Okay, so Bonnie says I will work on getting camera set up. Chris, I'm not sure whether you mean for tonight that you do want some coaching tonight. You don't have to have your camera if your audio works. It is nice to have both. So Jim's asking Bonnie, if you're doing money and you with DC Cordova, tell her Jim Bunch said hi. Okay, so pass the network along. very good. And so, Chris, can you give me feedback? Are you trying to come on tonight or are we good to go? And Jim, if you wanted to say anything before we call it a night, would you let me know that also? I see Jill is typing. This inspired me to step it up. It does, doesn't it? When you realize that just by talking through something and making a commitment and getting it done, that you actually step up your game, and it's so simple. It's really simple. Jill's asking, Jim, are you in Solana Beach? I thought I saw you walking your dog last night. Probably not walking a dog. Yeah, make sure you're all on the Victory Lap webinar. Absolutely. You will be blown away by not only the wins that everybody else posts, but the wins Jim helps you remember because unfortunately, we have short-term memory. With our wins, we can remember things we failed to do for a very long time. And I'm speaking for the majority of the public. You may be very different. Those remembering those wins, it's like, okay, done, check that off the list and move on. So the Victory Lap is really powerful in helping you with your wins. So Jim says for the Victory Lap, start a list of wins now. And you'll get a chance to share them all on the webinar. It's really empowering. Yeah, and no matter how many you think of, I guarantee you, Jim will prompt you to remember a few more by his special approach. Bonnie says, there's issues I need help with. A family relationship. All right, so Bonnie, did you want coaching tonight? Because I love to coach around relationship. All right, so let me give you, let me come up here and find you in my, there you are. And let me, oh, you're on mobile. Let's see if this works. Let's see if I can get you at least audio. I'm going to try voice first. Let's get you on voice. You should get permission or have to get permission on your side. And Bonnie, let me know when you see it coming through. For some reason, it's not coming through. Do you see anything on your side, Bonnie? There, I see you now. Try speakers. I've got it in listen only, Jim. Do I need to put that in question and answer? Probably. Let's try that. All right, Bonnie, try again. No, that's not going to do it either. It says make a presenter. Okay, let me go back to listen only. And that should, let me give you voice. So Bonnie, let me know what's, if there's anything showing on your side. Let me try audio and visual. So are you seeing anything on your side? The last thing I see from you, Bonnie, is that you'd like to have coaching if no one else. Can you all still hear me? Just checking. Okay, so you can still hear me. So, Bonnie, let me know what's going on your side, please. I've got you up, and actually it's showing you as a presenter.
Hear me?
Oh, here you come. Cool, welcome.
For some reason, when I'm on my headset, I had to go and get earphones. That's the only way it would work.
Okay, perfect. Well, good for being persistent. And
I know, it's a good thing that I had them with me.
Yes. I don't think you were on at the start when I introduced myself. So would you like me to reintroduce myself so you know who's coaching you?
I would love that. Yeah.
Well, hi, Bonnie. I'm Fran Henry. I am a certified coach with the Ultimate Game of Life, and I coach at all levels of the game. I'm also a Coach U graduate, and I've been coaching for about 14 years now. I'm not one to count years behind. I only count years in front. And so I'm guessing at the 14, it may be more. And I've been affiliated with and aware of and a participant in the Ultimate Game since it was the Happy, Healthy, Wealthy game. So very familiar with the game. So we're losing the vision. Yes, we see your hand.
I'm untangling my stuff here.
Okay. All right. Well, you let me know when you're ready and you can go ahead and
still talk.
Okay, so go ahead and tell me what it is you'd like some help with.
Well, I have a very large family. I'm one of six kids. I'm the oldest of six kids. And I've always been kind of like the responsible one, the second mom in the house, actually more mature than my own mother. And now, when my dad passed, wait, hold on one sec. When my dad passed, can you still hear me?
I can. Jill's saying she's having trouble hearing you. And that's probably because there was a lot of background noise while you were straightening things out. So Go ahead and
Oh,
talk for a
sorry.
minute. And Jill, if you're still having trouble hearing her, let me know.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you very well.
Okay. Well, hopefully Jill can hear me better. I'm holding the phone closer to my mouth, too.
Okay, now if you can also, before you start, Bonnie, if you can fix your camera so we see you instead of the board behind you. Should be able to
I
see
didn't want to be seen on camera.
Well, I can turn the video off if you prefer.
Yeah, turn the video off.
Okay. Actually, I think I just need to turn yours off.
Yeah, keep
it. All right, let's see. All right, let me find. Let me get back to yours. This is all new technology for me, and so thank you all for letting me play with it. Okay, so now her video is off, so that's fine.
Yay.
I'm used to just hearing.
Okay, good. Yeah. Okay, so
all right.
My mom, because there's six kids, when my dad died, my mom came to live with me, and she lived with me for several years. And then when I went through my divorce, she went and lived with my brother, and she's kind of bounced around from family member to family member. And for some reason, whenever she's with a family member, it's like all of us, I've done this too, we don't financially help the family member that is taking care of everything. But years ago, my dad's been dead 21 years now, it hasn't been an issue because my mom has always been helpful, you know, like if you have children, she'd help you with the children or whatever you need. It was like having a roommate there. Well, my mom has Alzheimer's now, and it's a whole different story. And it's not like that anymore. And she's living with my brother, Gary, the youngest of the second youngest of the family. And I said that we should all contribute to Gary. It would cost $700 a month for each of us, and it would support Gary so that Gary, who said he was willing to do this and wanted to do this, to take care of my mom. He's also getting his license so that he could help and take care of other people too, and that he decided this is the path he wants to take. So, but my other brothers and sisters are causing a lot of problems. They don't want to give Gary any money. They don't want to help. It wasn't doing enough for me doing it on my own. And my half of us want to put my mom in a home. And my brother, myself, and my other sister don't want to. So now the three that wanted to put my mom in a home and don't want to contribute have all alienated me as the troublemaker, and they won't talk to me anymore. And it's kind of painful, and I don't know how to deal with that.
Okay, so this is a perfect example of why the relationship environment is the most difficult, because each one of the people have their own nine environments. And what you're trying to get everybody to do is to agree where all of those different environments overlap each other. So you all meet in relationship environment, but you also have all your own other environments, including the mimetic environment, which you described beautifully, that you all have different ideas, thoughts, or beliefs about the way this should happen. First of all, let me tell you, I can unbelievably relate to your story because I'm one of seven children.
Oh, wow.
I was the oldest girl. I had two older brothers.
Oh my God.
And
okay.
My mother had a 10-year experience of Alzheimer's.
Oh,
and
gosh.
The girls did 99% of taking care of her. So I do know what I'm talking about from my perspective, but that's my nine environments. So Bonnie, we're going to concentrate on yours. So of all the things you told us, the getting the family to agree, the taking care of the mom, this sort of thing, are you clear, fully clear on what you want your role to be? Just
as
your
far as taking
role.
Care of my mom?
As far as whatever you're talking about your mother.
It's not only about my mother. That's just what the issue is. I think what I want to do is just love one another, be respectful of one another, listen to what the other one has to say, understand their position, but also
yes.
realize that we may not always agree.
And that doesn't mean we don't love each other. You know, that we want to alienate each other and say you're dead to me. And that's like the way that they're acting. And just because of a difference in opinion, it's really hurtful.
Yeah, it is. And it also sounds like you're hoping that you can help them upgrade their relationship environment. Is that true?
Well, I'm sure that it would in the process do that, but if they don't care, they don't care. I mean, there's nothing I could do about it. I just don't know how to make that okay with me. I mean, it's sad.
Yes. So that in anything that you do, you really have only control over yourself, and sometimes not even that. Would you agree with that? Sometimes we don't control ourselves well, okay?
Yeah, so, like when myself tells me go downstairs and get something to eat at 10 o'clock at night when I don't need it.
Yes.
And sometimes I don't have any control.
Yes. Yes. And so that's, Jim spoke to that. That's the power of environment.
Uh-huh.
When your relationship environment interacts with the rest of your family, it sounds like one of the best interactions you have is with your brother Gary. Is that correct?
Yeah, Gary and Lori, I have the best.
Okay.
Kim, Linda, and David are the difficult ones.
Okay.
They're more headstrong and more selfish than the other two.
Okay. So what I'm hearing is that there's judgment about how the others are choosing to be. If you were
Let me explain where I was coming from. I'm working with a woman named Gina Jones, and she's a Magi, and we work with the cards, and we're doing a documentary on the cards. And I happened to learn recently that the three of them are aces, and aces are the most selfish cards in the deck. It's all about me. And I'm like, oh my God. And she goes, and you have three siblings that are aces. And that's why you're having a hard time with that. Cause I'm the queen of heart, the loving mother. That's my card, the loving mother that I want to give to the world. And I want everybody to be, I don't like problems. I like to make everybody get along. And I'm always the peacemaker and helping everybody. And that's why I have a hard time with it. So I was only repeating what I just learned about the card that they represent.
Okay. And there still is judgment there, and that's neither good or bad. It's actually good if you understand that they are different and can honor that difference instead of expecting them to be different than who they came to be. And I want to take just a quick break here for a moment. I could go into a two-hour dissertation on this because I have dealt with this, but I want to help you, Bonnie, with what we can do tonight, which I hope you'll start to watch as you go into relationships with others. And so what I want you to look at for a moment is, if you think of, are you familiar with the chakras? You know, anybody that doesn't understand what I'm talking about when I say chakras, the energy centers within our body.
Yeah, I actually bought a book on it recently.
Okay. So is there anybody else listening, Jill, Brian, any of you who have not heard the word and understand that they're energy centers? So in the body, when one energy center, maybe it's the power center or the heart center or the voice energy, one of those, when it gets bigger, creative, you know, when a woman's pregnant, that's her creative energy visually expanding. And what does it do to what's on top and what's below it? Bonnie, what does that expanding creative energy do to what's on top and what's below?
It affects those areas too.
It actually diminishes them. It pushes them out of the way so it can grow, doesn't it? So yeah.
I didn't
so
think
what
of
are
it
you
like
hearing?
That, like it pushes them out of the way.
Yeah. So what are you hearing? What
I
just hit?
That, yeah.
So how does that apply to relationship?
How does it apply that if if they're pushing me away, it's some other area that they're working on or that they're have their focus on that's squishing their relationship area.
Yeah, you all are actually fighting for space, or in this case, fighting for the right to be you.
To be me.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, you are. Absolutely. Yeah. And that's both the blessing and the curse of large family. The blessing is if you can learn to get along in a large family, you can get along in the world. But if you have trouble getting along in a large family or even a small one, then you're going to have that experience in all of your outer environments. So what's coming to you? What's the resolve of this?
What's the what? The resolve?
Yeah. What are you sensing inside of you that you have control over that might start to resolve this?
Well, I don't know. I mean, what I've been doing is just focusing on getting rid of my clutter, my stuff in my relationship areas. I've been looking at feng shui and trying to put loving photos of them in areas of the heart and putting, you know, candles around it and clearing the area, throwing out trash, putting new lighting, doing everything to be more open and to be more aware and to see myself.
Perfect. Perfect. And there's one more part to that, the part where your relationship overlaps your brothers and sisters. Can you let them be them?
Oh, I'm just not having a problem with them being them. I have a problem with them being them and not wanting me.
Okay.
That's the pain.
But that is them right now.
Yeah.
That is them right now. And here's one more thing. So I'm going to put my hands up. Imagine that you are putting yours up. I'm one of your most obstinate. I'm going to use a word I would use if my family was doing that. Most obstinate.
Now I know what you're going to do. When you push against it versus when you don't. Yeah.
Yeah. So you and I are pushing and pushing and pushing. And one of us is going to fatigue. And then the other person, what? What happens with the other person? They win That's, or they
well,
lose?
Then the other, yeah. Well, if we were pushing against each other and you got tired, then I would fall forward.
Yeah, but you also would consider you won. Right?
Uh-huh.
Okay. So the minute you start pushing against each other, you're looking for a winner and a loser.
Right.
What I learned to do, I don't put my hands up. I don't resist. I just step out of the way.
Yeah.
And I let them be them. And it actually brought peace in my family. And I can tell you that each one of the family members then found what it was they could and would do. So the one brother who just could not be around his mother with Alzheimer's, and I later found out there was a really good reason for that, which I won't go into, but he found that he could help keep her house in order. He'd go by and make repairs, or he'd get somebody to do that. So he took care of her physical environment.
Right.
That was his step up, because nobody required him to do something that was not in his strengths and his nature. So looking at this again, because I want you to come away with one thing that feels pretty easy to start doing tonight. What could you start doing tonight to honor who you came to be and to allow them to be who they are being right now and leave it up to them whether they change or not? Because let me go back to what I heard, because we can talk specifics with this one. You said everyone needs to put up $700 a month. Is that one of the big issues?
It was. My brother just a couple weeks ago, he's getting some help from the government now. So it's a smaller amount of money. It's not as big of an issue, but they don't put their time in. They don't either. I mean, I take my mom every Friday, And she's always, I mean, with Alzheimer's, she'll say something 100 times. So she'll keep complaining about them the whole time I'm with them that they don't call her or she hasn't seen them. But even if she does see them, she forgets.
Right.
So.
Right. So there's a couple of, I'm going to make a couple of suggestions that I don't usually make as a coach, but because I hear what you're going through and because I've been through it and actually thrived through it, I can tell you now the lessons I learned about life dealing with my mother with Alzheimer's have been invaluable to me. One of them is let people choose how to be around them because everybody's going to experience it differently. You make your choices and let everybody else make theirs. And the other is to be a detective. When you come into her space, and this is really true for anybody, but particularly people with Alzheimer's, when you come into their space, become a detective and see who they are that day, what role are they playing, and therefore, what role can you play? And it really struck home to me when I asked my mom one time how old, she wanted to know why her hands looked so bad. And I said to her, well, those are age spots. And she said, well, how old am I? And I made the mistake of telling her the truth. I said, 80. And she fired at me and she said, that's not true. That can't possibly be true. And so she had a fit because in her mind, which is her reality, she was 40. I asked her, I said, how old do you think you are? And she said, I don't know. And I said, well, if you could guess, what would you guess? And she said, 40. Well, I had gray hair, and I was trying to be her daughter at 40. Do you see why that doesn't work?
Yeah.
You cannot change somebody else's reality, whether they have Alzheimer's or not. Yours is the only reality you can change, and you're working on your memetics. You're controlling what you can control, which is your beliefs. If you have a belief somebody should be different than they are, you're setting both of you up or hands against each other.
Right.
So that's why I said there's some judgment involved here. So now I want to check back in with you, Bonnie, because I'm doing far more talking than I usually do in coaching. And I want to check back in with you. And where are we with helping you with this relationship?
I'm not sure if I follow the question.
Where are we?
How's it helped what you said?
Yes.
Well, I like your what you said about the hands because I do, I get that. Don't push because when you push, when you do a pushback, that's engaging and that's like a tug of war. Where if you just let it go and you don't do that, there's nothing to push against. They will have nothing to push against. And eventually it might clear the situation itself. And I should put my focus on something else in my environment or make have more things in my environment instead of focusing on the things that aren't working in it.
Yeah, or find other alternatives as the brother who went to the government did. You know, you put out there what you want and if everybody steps up, wonderful. If a few step up, good. If somebody figures out another way, wonderful. Look for other alternatives. Anytime you're trying to reach a goal, it's pretty much an experiment. You try something. If it doesn't work, what do you do?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Try something else, right?
Yeah. Thank you.
So you're welcome. You're welcome. And so, Bonnie, I want to know, what can you take away from what we did tonight? Keep it simple. What's one simple thing that you can practice over the next week so that we get a great win when you come back on the victory lap?
You mean a practice for the relationship between my brother, sister? Well, I'm not going to engage them, number one, so I won't reach out to them anymore.
Okay.
So.
So you don't create the opportunity for the resistance.
Correct.
Right? Now, that didn't sound like that gives you energy. Is there something else you can do, something you can put your focus on or something you can do to upgrade your relationship environment that would feel like this was a win rather than a default to the best of the not fun choices.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know what that is.
Okay. So let me just talk with you for a minute. Is there something that you need in relationship that maybe your family is not the right group to bring it to you? Do you have a need in relationship that you could get met in a different way?
Yeah, I have a lot of needs in relationships that I'm not getting from my family.
Okay.
All of them. Every single okay. need that a relationship could possibly have, I do not get from my family.
Okay, perfect. So pick one. What's one need that if you got that met, you would say, wow, that's what a good relationship gives. What would be one
love.
Need? Love. Okay. So, and I'm guessing you mean to both give and receive love.
Correct.
Okay. So do you have in your wider network, do you have someone who knows how to give and receive love?
Not really.
Okay. So that might be the first place to look. They may be there and you just haven't seen it because you thought it should come from family. But I can tell you that finding it anywhere from the right person is 100% better than finding it somewhere with the wrong person.
Right.
So would you make a commitment to the group tonight to be willing?
Oh my God.
Just to be willing. This is simple. I promise you I keep it simple. To be willing to find someone who's healthy enough to give and receive love. Just to be willing for that person to show up.
I'm oh gosh. Yes, I'm willing and open to receive and to give love. And
okay.
I don't want
okay.
to seem desperate, you know what I mean?
You're not.
It sounds
you,
so desperate.
No, it is not desperate. Listen, one of the programs that we use in the 90 day, and particularly I send it out to my teams in the mastery program, is called the Needless Program. And in that, you identify your basic needs. And then you set up a system of getting them met in healthy ways. If we keep going, I heard it today in a meeting I was in. If we keep going to the hardware store for a loaf of bread, we keep getting disappointed. It's really, really important to go to the right place to get needs met in a healthy way. And family is not always there to do that. If they're not, and you accept it, and you become willing to receive it in other ways, I can tell you it'll feel a lot better when you get met in a healthy way than when you get it met or continue to be disappointed from the people that you want it from who are not capable.
True.
Okay, so that needs are normal. The old, did you grow up being told don't be needy?
Yep.
Okay. That's a mimetic. That needs to be rewritten. To we all have needs. We have a right to get our needs met in a healthy way.
I grew up that way. That's why you keep breaking up.
Oh, I'm sorry. You have a right to get your needs met in a healthy way. We all have needs. I'm at my best game when I'm getting my needs met in a healthy way. Did you get that?
Yes.
Okay. So I want to go back because the first step is always to be willing. Will you be willing this week to look for ways, people, relationships that are healthy and can give and receive love?
Yes.
Okay.
I am
that
ready,
sounded
willing,
believable.
And able.
Yes, you are. That sounded believable. Absolutely. Okay, Bonnie. Are you good
very,
with that?
Very much.
You're welcome.
Yes, thank
You're
you,
welcome.
Fran.
You're welcome. And if you want to post on Facebook, if you have some issues and you want to post, I'm telling you, I'm not the only one who's been through what you're going through. That's the power of this community to help support you. That may be one way to get a need met.
Okay.
Just a hint.
Thank you.
No promises. Okay. So, yeah, that was perfect, wasn't it? That was my email popping up, but that was a nice sound. Perfect timing. Okay, so thank you, Bonnie, for bringing that. I think that was powerful, and I'm hopeful that that rang true for everyone and that we showed why a relationship can be one of the more difficult but also one of the most rewarding environments to work on. So did you have anything else you wanted to say before I close off your audio?
No, I'm great. Thank you very much. I was lucky me. I had two in a row.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. All right. Well, you have a good evening. And let
Thank
us
you.
Know what comes into your life now that you're willing to have that need met in a healthy way.
Thank you very much. I will.
All right.
Thank
okay.
You.
So you're welcome. So I just want to check in with you all now. First, my first question is, gee, anybody else have issues with relationship that you learned something tonight? And if so, Tenzin, I see that you're on too. Let me see what time we are. And well, we got just a couple minutes. Tenzin, we need to bring you on this side so we can talk. And if so, I will do that. And so in the meantime, what I want is for those of you who are listening, I want to know what you got out of that, and if you can make a similar commitment to at least be willing to change some of the beliefs around needing something, and also the beliefs around what you expect or the expectations, let me change it, to other people. So Tenzin, let me know when you get an audio here. You should get grant permission from your side. Gave you audio first, and are you willing to? I'm not sure what the delay is, but I did send you permission to start. Okay, so we're waiting for your response now. This is just the audio right now, and then I'll get permission to turn the video on if you're good with that, which I hope so. And so Jodine said it was an eye-opener, gives me a lot to think about and really look at some relationships in my life versus needs. Yes, just because the people are closest to you, meaning they're in your home or have been, doesn't mean that they need to get all your needs met. They should be busy getting their needs met. And if they're not the right one to meet your need, find someone who is. And I'm talking about spouses, parents, children, whatever the generation. We're still waiting for your response, Tenzin, so let me know what you're seeing on your side. Brian says, I had the realization that I have been relying on getting my needs met by default rather than by design. Absolutely. It's kind of default when you just expect somebody because they're physically present or on the other end of a phone to expect them to be the ones to get your needs met. Find people who get your needs met in healthy ways. Let's see, Tenzin. I'm going to hit the video just in case it works better to have both of them on. It's still saying, waiting for a response on your side. Are you seeing anything, Tenzin, from your side? Type into the chat, please. And anyone else who's on who found some value in that coaching, I'd love to see what that coaching did for you and what you can take forward to work on upgrading that relationship environment. It's pretty powerful. Okay, so Tenzin, anything going on? Let me start over with you. Just give it one more try before we call it a night. All right, so I'm giving yes to start. It's waiting for your response. My video just flashed. Sometimes that means you're coming on because it's testing the system. Or it's just getting tired. I'm not sure. Okay, it clicked off again. One more try, and then we're going to call it an evening. Waiting for your response. You should click an allow or a yes on your sign. Anything on your side, Tenzin? Okay, well, I'm going to pick out some music that I think will will help us. How about Happy? I think we want a happy feeling to go out with, and I just love this song. So let me put that music on. Thank you all for showing up. Remember, Tuesday night, Victory Lap, between now and Tuesday night, start writing down your wins, and I guarantee no matter how many you come up with, because you'll get to enter them all into the chat, no matter how many you come up with, Jim has a way to help you remember more. So I'm looking forward to that. And then also remember, he is going to tell you a little more about the Ultimate 90-Day Challenge. And so I look forward to seeing that with you. So, okay, here comes your music. And thank you all for tuning in. See you Tuesday on the Victory Lap. This is Fran Henry reminding you it is your choice to create your ultimate life, including getting your needs met in a healthy way. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.
And there's no more lies, and the darkness is light.